I swore an oath to defend our Constitution, West Point, two tours in Kuwait.
It's been a long journey leading Yinka Faleti from Lagos, Nigeria to candidacy for Missouri Secretary of State. He moved to the U.S. at the age of 7 and after moving around as a child, earned an appointment to the U.S. Military Academy at West Point. He served for 6 years as a combat arms officer in the U.S. Army, including 2 deployments to the Middle East. But after leaving the Army, graduating from law school and working in both private practice and as a state prosecutor, it was a different event that inspired him to serve again. The 2014 shooting of teenager Michael Brown by a police officer in Ferguson, Missouri, made Faleti reevaluate how he could make an impact. He wanted to help rectify the deep inequalities he saw in his community.
I began to realize that many of the issues we were working on, when we pulled the thread back on those issues, the thread ended at the state level. I needed to get to the state level, and that's why I'm running. And specifically for Secretary of State, because that's where the fight is for democracy in our state.
Faleti is one of a large number of first or second generation Americans of African descent running for office in the U.S. He recently received a message from a young man on the African continent who had watched his campaign video and wrote to say it made him hopeful.
And that just touched me in such a special way, that to know that halfway across the world, there's a young man who saw this, our 2-minute bio video, and has hope for not only himself, but all of the youth across Nigeria who can see themselves and say, hey, you know what? If he was able to do this, maybe I can do it too. Not necessarily run for office, but the idea that I can have some level of success. I can make it out of my current condition, whatever that condition may be. And that just inspired me and energized me even more.
Ngozi Akubuike is a candidate for district court judge in Ramsey County, Minnesota. She was also born in Nigeria, but her journey was very different. She practiced law in her home country, but came to the U.S. through the diversity visa lottery. Within 3 months of arriving, she found herself homeless with her several-week-old baby in her arms.
The journey was not an easy one for me, but I made a promise to that baby that homelessness will not be our final destination. And so I went back to law school.
After a career as a prosecutor and as a coordinator and legal manager for the Americans with Disability Act in Minnesota, she wants to bring her life experience to the judicial bench.
One thing I tell people is no experience is wasted. I let people know there is always a reason for someone to go through that experience. And I believe that I went through those experiences in order to teach me that adversity does not define who a person is.
Akubuike said her life experience has shown her, having seen things from a position of being underprivileged, she believes she can bring that empathy to the bench.
We need people with diverse backgrounds, people who have experienced true life, people who have experienced adversity. We need everyone, every background on the bench so that you can connect with the people.
The candidates will get their answers from voters on election day. Salem Solomon, VOA News, Washington.